everyone to be here today. That's finally arrived. We are so glad you survived all the hype and jive. Now we are here to send you cheer and help you celebrate. This is all so great. Look at who's here. They are all so dear. We are here in Dad's Land on Manitou Land. Well, look at my brothers. They are like no others. My brothers, Don and Robin, asked me to speak for them so that we do not reiterate what we collectively believe to be so true about our mom, Fern and Air. There is also another very important group of people here tonight, mom's friends. Many of mom's friends also have passed on and are physically unable to attend, so I want to thank Sonia and John for representing mom's lifelong friends. 85, you bravely decided to carve your life in Manitou. You were blessed with a group of new friends who have sustained you. What a blessing. Let's raise a toast to all your friends, past and present. When we think about you, there are three general descriptors that we hope best describe you, Mom, and explain why we hold you so close to our hearts. These three attributes are, number one, generous heart, number two, inspiring, number three, genuine. Number one, generous heart. I think it's fitting that we celebrate your birthday here at Dad's Land because your heart is as big as Dad's Land. You are deeply about all of us and have bent over backwards to please us and provide what we needed. Over the years, you have made sure you had the opportunity to connect with all your grandchildren and great-grandchildren by inviting them to stay with you and Dad over the years. As we all started having our own children, I remember you saying, I want to get to know my grandchildren and I want them to get to know me. And I think it's a testament to you that they're all here except one, Angela, tonight that couldn't make it. And that's really impressive that they could all come to your party tonight. So thank you guys for being here. Another example of your generous heart is your house on 12th Street in Saskatoon. We labeled it, I don't know if it was our dad that labeled it, or Ben, Fern's Hotel. So because why? You opened the door for everyone, family and friends who needed a place to stay in time of need. And you did that year after year after year. So number two, inspiring. Who in this room is not inspired by Fern and Air? To be 90 and in good health with your spirit strongly intact is a testament to how you looked after yourself physically, mentally, and spiritually. You were also a very hardworking elementary school teacher at a time when most mothers were staying at home. We were always, my brothers and I, were always very proud of you for that. You had done a lot, you had a lot on your plate, and you rose above it, still faithfully baking breads and buns every Saturday morning. Saturdays were always the best days for us at our house, smelling that freshly baked bread. You could have gone to the store and bought Wonder Bread, but you chose to give us the best. There is no pretense about you, Mom. You were honest by saying what you want, and you've learned not to say what you want when it is better not to say anything at all. At 90, you are genuinely wise. You have a certain look about you that has been captured in the drawing that's up on the stage that your grandson Robin did of you when you were 6 years old. It's that 5 years old. That certain glint in your eye when you smile. I would like to describe this look about you as knowing spirit with a hint of mischief. You are genuinely a lot of fun to be around. It doesn't take much to have a laugh with you. I don't know how many times you have been a good friend to me by laughing until tears come to our eyes. Especially when we try to do mental math in our head. Most of the time, we are laughing at ourselves, which is a good quality I've learned from you. So, from all of us, thank you for your generosity in hosting this party tonight. Thank you for all of you for being here. I think we're all really blessed, and I know that I'm speaking for all of you, that we hold you very dear to our heart. And I would like to now raise a toast to the classy birthday girl, Fern.
We're going to start with the local MLA. He said a little thank you for being 90. You know his name, huh? Your MLA? He didn't vote for him. His name is Greg Burkich. And he sent a nice happy 90th birthday card to your card table.
This is an air on behalf of the government of Saskatchewan. I'm pleased to offer best wishes to you on your 90th birthday. Joyous memories of this occasion as you celebrate with family and friends. May each and every passing year bring you wisdom, peace, and good health. Your birthday is a special time to celebrate the gift of you to the world. This is often unknown, and signed, Brad Wall, Premier of Saskatchewan.
The Lieutenant Governor of Saskatchewan, Mother, sent you a card. She sent this card to you as well. We're going to have some cake now.
Did you hear that?
And then we're going to party. Yeah.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Fern, happy birthday to you.
I think it's time to look at the cake that Kimber and Elijah got ready for us, and there's pictures on it.
There's Bill and me and my kids.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Fern. Happy birthday to you. I want to celebrate to see the shining in your eyes.
Now Fern has grandkids all around. They ask their grandma what lies ahead. When I have rainbows day after day, here's what their grandma said. Kesara, sirrah, I feel wonderful. as wonderful as can be. It makes me want to say things to somebody new. And by the way, I've been meaning to say, I think you're wonderful too. We know she's wonderful, as wonderful as can be. We celebrate with you. We won't have it any other way. So here's to you, 90 years young. Fern, happy birthday today.
Amen, see, I can do me song. Amen, Robo. Amen, Robo. Amen, see, I can do me song. Amen, Robo. Amen, see, I can do me song.
I just want to say thank you, Grandma, for inviting us here. It's been really great.
Happy birthday to Grandma. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you very much, everyone, for coming. This is lovely. I mean, I can't speak. I'm so grateful to all my family who helped to put this on, and to all my good friends in Saskatoon, in the beach here, at the beach here. And I want to recognize that my oldest friend here, Sonia and John, I think we've known each other for 35 years. And also, I have something very special. I taught school, as you know, and I have a student here from my very first student, Erwin, and I'd like him to stand up and everybody see. There he is. At White School District, just about 10 miles northeast of Yellowgrass, and Erwin was in grade 4. Wow. And I was about 20, I think. And as you know, I came out here when I was 85 years old and met a wonderful group of people. Judy, who traveled from Alberta, from Grand Prairie, and Joy, my goodness, from Victoria, and Ron and Janet from Calgary, and all my wonderful grandkids, and well, everybody. It's lovely. Thank you so much. Yeah. Oh, and John, Joy and Audrey are my nieces. There's Audrey. They're like my sisters. They're pretty got it. Anyway, thank you again. I hope you have enjoyed the rest of your day.